Friends, today we will see what are prime numbers and also what are prime number magic squares and prism magic squares. Prism magic squares are very excellent topic. Okay, they are very fascinating. First we will see what are prime numbers. Okay, prime numbers are any number that are divisible by 1 and also by itself. For example, 3 is a prime number. 3 is divisible by 1 and also 3 is divisible by 3 itself. 5 is a prime number. 5 is divisible by 1 and also 5 is divisible by 5. 7 is a prime number. 7 is divisible by 1 and also by itself. Like that. But whereas 9 is not a prime number. 9 is divisible by 1 and also it is divisible by 9. It is also divisible by 3. So any number which is divisible by other than a number apart from 1 and 9 is called a composite number. So 9 is a composite number. 8, 18, 16, 15, etc. are all composite numbers. 2 is the only even prime number. Okay. Since 2 is a prime number, all the numbers that are all the even numbers cannot be a prime number because all the even numbers will be divisible by 2. So, what are consecutive prime numbers? For example, 11 and 13 are considered to be consecutive primes because there is only one number that is separating them. Again, 17 and 19 are consecutive primes because only one number, 18, separates them. So, these are the base, some of the rudimentary basic things about prime numbers. And prime numbers were thought to be an area of pure mathematics. G.H. Hardy, a great mathematician who has devoted his life entirely to mathematics, he never married. G.H. Hardy, he would say that his best discovery was the discovery of Srinivasa Ramanujan. So, he was working in prime numbers. He prided himself that he was in the realm of pure mathematics. So, he detested the applied mathematics because that was the time when World War I has ended, and so he had seen a lot of death and destruction caused by the science, and science and mathematics are inseparable. So, because of that, he detested the applied mathematics and he devoted entirely to the pure mathematics. Or rather, he thought it was pure mathematics. But there is nothing called as pure and applied mathematics. What is today pure mathematics would tomorrow become applied mathematics. For example, Leonhard Euler, who lived about 350 years back, he devoted himself to several practical problems in the mathematics. Leonhard Euler worked on a problem called Königsberg Bridge problem. So, Königsberg was a river island connected to the mainland through several bridges. So, that was a traversal problem he was working on. We'll look more into the Königsberg Bridge problem sometime later, some other video. Today, the Königsberg Bridge problem is not only used in the finding the optimization of the path. It is also used in the optimization of the neural networks. It is also used in the optimization of the neural circuits. And it is used in the database optimization. It has got several applications today in the computer. When the Leonhard Euler worked on the Königsberg Bridge problem, there was no concept of computer. Nobody thought computer would be coming after about few centuries later. As when the Euler worked on the problem, he saw that as a pure mathematics. And now it has become applied mathematics. So when Hardy worked on prime numbers, it was a pure mathematics. It was in the area of pure mathematics. Hardy never thought there would be any application for the prime numbers. But now, about 70 years back, six or seven decades ago, people have found out, 70 scientists and mathematicians have found out a very practical application for the prime numbers. Today, if there were no prime numbers, there is no ATM credit card transaction that is possible. Now we are able to do that ATM credit card transactions very securely using the prime numbers. So that would not have been possible. That is called something called as public key encryption. So that is the system used in cryptography and also in the area of ATM credit card, etc. Without that, our codes would be wide open. That is broken open very easily, and all our money could be stolen from the banks. So that is the practical application for the mathematics. So once my mother, Indira Narasinghe Rao, she has constructed a 8x8 magic square in her own way. That is a unique way. And she also she has also scaled it to 1000 by 1000 in her own method, and she has found an entry in the LIMCA book of records. She asked P.K. Srinivasan, a retired mathematics school teacher. Though he was a retired mathematics school teacher, he was widely respected even in IITs. Okay, IITs, IIM. Lot of foreign dignitaries, foreign mathematicians would visit Ramanujan Museum when he was the director of the Ramanujan Museum. Such was his caliber, such was his contacts. His love for, passion for mathematics is legendary. Mr. P.K. Srinivasan said to my mother, see, today something could be pure mathematics. Tomorrow there could be some application could be found for that. Mathematicians don't worry about the applications for their discoveries. They are only bothered about the observation of the nature, observation of the principle, recording, coming out with theorem, formula, etc., etc. They are only trying to decipher the nature. So application part comes very later. He used to say like that. So much for the introduction of prime numbers and pure mathematics and applied mathematics. Now we will be going into the prism magic squares. I have seen lot of magic squares in my life. I am not a big mathematician, but I have discovered certain concepts in magic squares. So I have also created a magic square puzzle. There is an app also called magic square puzzle available in the Play Store. Kindly download it and play that. Okay. But thing is that I have seen lot of magic squares. My mother herself has constructed 1000 by 1000 magic square, etc., etc. But I am baffled by this prism magic squares. About 350 years ago in Europe, there lived a person. Probably he was a prison inmate and he found no way to escape. So what he did was that he used prime numbers to construct a magic square. There are two such squares that he constructed. One was the 7 by 7, another was a 13 by 13. In the 7 by 7 magic square that we are seeing here, see, it gives a total of a magic sum of 27,627. So, but if you remove the numbers, last digit of every number, for example, 11 becomes 1, 3851 becomes 385, 9257 becomes 925, 1747 becomes 174, etc., etc., you again get a magic square and its magic sum is 2760. This same prison inmate has created a 13 by 13 magic square using entirely prime numbers. So you will be baffled by this also. So 13 by 13 gives a magic sum of 70,681. You remove the outer rows and outer columns, you get 11 by 11. And the 11 by 11 magic square gives you a magic sum of 59,807. You once again remove the outermost rows and columns, it becomes a 9 by 9 magic square. The 9 by 9 magic square gives you a magic sum of 48,933. Again you remove the outermost rows and columns and you get a 7 by 7 magic square. The magic sum of the 7 by 7 magic square is 38059. Again you remove the outermost rows and columns, you get a 5 by 5 magic square and its magic sum is 27185. Again you remove the outermost rows and columns, you get a 3 by 3 magic square. The magic sum of this 3 by 3 magic square is 16,311. So that is his prison magic square. We don't know who the gentleman was, what his name was, where he lived, nothing is known to us. Only these two magic squares are there. Okay. Now in the recent times, Alan W. Johnson has constructed several magic squares using prime numbers. So one of them is the 4 by 4 that we are seeing here. And the magic sum of the 4 by 4 magic square is 258. There is also one more magic square. This one is 5 by 5. It also uses entirely the prime numbers. And its magic sum is 1703. All of you must have heard about Martin Gardner. He is a renowned mathematician. He contributes mainly to the Scientific American. And he had floated a competition to his audience, stating that anybody who creates a 3 by 3 magic square using consecutive primes would be rewarded with $100. And Harry Nelson was the one who took up that challenge and he created a 3 by 3 using consecutive primes. So the magic sum of that consecutive prime is 4,440,084,513. That is the magic sum. Okay, we can see lot of such interesting tidbits, interesting facts about the magic squares, prime numbers, etc. in our coming sections. If you like my channel, kindly press the subscribe button and press the notification icon. And also kindly like, share and comment in my video. Thank you. Good day. Bye.